Hi, and welcome back to Calm, Cool, and Connected. We are so supportive of our military community here at Calm, Cool, and Connected, and I'm so excited to introduce our guest for the show today, who also shares that same vision of being supportive of our active duty and veterans in our community. Welcome, Kayla Fallon Aristivo, President of Trails of Purpose and Registered Interning Counseling. Kayla, welcome.
Hi, Rachel Ann. Thank you so much for having me.
Yes, absolutely. So I want to just launch right into this and just ask you, what is the importance of recognizing our military service members, either active duty or veteran? What is that importance for you?
Well, the importance for me is that as the military community, they have such specific needs. They are regular human beings like you and I, but they have a trained mindset that we expect them to have and engage in their life after going through training. They also experience very specific and unique circumstances compared to regular civilians. And the demand and the pressures on their life to follow authority and have decisions made for them is far greater than the civilian world. And on top of that, the trauma that they experience in combat or in training exercises here stateside is so great and can lead to such a feeling of isolation that the rest of the world doesn't understand what I'm experiencing or going through. And so for me, as a survivor of trauma myself, I understood at a young age how important it would be for me to have community and people who understand similar traumas. And so Trails of Purpose was really born out of the desire to engage with our military community and have them be innovative in how they create community around themselves so that they don't feel isolated.
I agree with you 100% that the military culture is so different from civilian life, and just giving those individuals a place to share and feel heard. Kayla, you mentioned, and I want to ask you this because I have found that oftentimes our life purpose is born from our own experiences and we start to find our passion and our mission. Was there something that happened for you that propelled you to create Trails of Purpose?
Oh, absolutely. So my father had passed away on September 11th, 2001. He worked in the Twin Towers. And I had some PTSD growing up as a kid, severe anxiety, depression, anger, suicide tendencies. I had gone through a bout of addiction in my early adolescence. And I knew what trauma, terrorism could do to a person, to a family.
Yes.
And from there, I kind of decided when I was done fighting myself, when I was about 19, 20 years old, I said, why am I fighting myself for the things that have been done to me? So I'm not going to do that anymore. Instead, I'm going to go out and fight for others who are going through the same thing that I was and kind of repurpose the bad that has happened to me for good.
Thank you so much for sharing your slice of your life journey, because Kayla, I think that that is what decreases, you know, the stigma surrounding asking for help, reaching out. And then what an inspiration. I'm inspired just hearing everything that you have gone through and how you've been able to turn that into this mission to help other people. So tell us a little bit more about Trails of Purpose. And then I also know that you're a resident in counseling. So was that also born from a passion to help others too?
Yeah. So I had very abruptly switched from being a business major in college to pursuing psychology for my undergrad and clinical mental health counseling as my master's degree program. Trails of Purpose is a nonprofit that provides free mental health counseling to the military community, active, retired, or dependent spouses and children. And we specialize in equine-assisted psychotherapy, so horse therapy. We offer it in marriage and family sessions, and we offer it in individual sessions. As I was growing in my career independent from Trails of Purpose prior to it starting and the foundation of it, but just really becoming passionate about helping the military community and, you know, learning of the suicide rates and how, you know, just a simple, you know, community outreach could probably make some difference. And so we can't, Trails of Purpose isn't going after the entire nation and the Department of Veteran Affairs and trying to revamp that, but we're starting local in our community. We're starting here in Hampton Roads and Virginia Beach and Chesapeake and Isle of Wight and saying, you know what? We have such a dense military population here. And we just absolutely need to be the ones that are reaching out and checking in on our neighbors.
I think it's fabulous. I'm just such a fan of animal assisted therapy, and I'm interested in hearing, and I'm sure the viewers and listeners would be too. What are the benefits of equine assisted therapy? How does it help? What are the modalities that you all use?
So we focus on a ground-based model, meaning that we are not riding horses when we come out. Although we can offer that as kind of a recreational thing to engage in. Our equine-assisted psychotherapy is a ground-based model. So you're working with the horse on the ground, and we take things from our talk sessions, because there's some times that we'll have a sit-down talk session, and we'll take the things that we're processing, the hard stuff, and then we'll go out and we'll work with a horse. We've got quite a few therapy horses, and we'll go and apply an exercise that can kind of help you build skills off of the things or process through the things that we're working on. For example, if we're working on trust building or communication within a marriage, maybe we'll work through a training exercise with the horse where one partner is blindfolded or closing their eyes, and the other partner, the spouse, has to, you know, tell them which direction to go in, and you're purely relying on communication there and trust building. So just kind of a brief, you know, overview of what that would look like tangibly in a session.
Wonderful. Yeah, I like that it's such a unique approach and really seeks to target and teach skills and coping strategies. Kayla, it's wonderful. I'm so glad that you're here. What have been some of the positive benefits from using horses almost in that therapeutic modality? What have you seen it help with? What kinds of issues?
Oh my gosh. Well, I mean, right off the bat, it takes us from a 10, I mean, pretty much instantly down to a 6 on average from when I see my clients coming in. And maybe they're apprehensive about going and working on some stuff, or this is their first time coming out. So it gives you something to do with your hands. You know, you're not just sitting there in an office. Sometimes that can kind of be nerve-wracking, especially for our military community who are used to being hypervigilant, up and about, moving around. And so, you know, being in nature, being outside, being at a barn, you know, hearing the birds chirp, feeling the sunshine or the fresh air, that in itself is therapeutic and has some really wonderful biological effects. And then when we're working with the horse, you know, you're working with an animal that is 1,000 pounds up to, oh my gosh, 2,000 pounds, depending on the horse. And you've got to have some really good patience and humility to get the horse to want to connect with you and engage with you. If you're up here and hypervigilant, the horse is going to go, oh my gosh, why are you freaking out? What do I need to be concerned about? Because the horses are typically, they're, you know, looking around and at a fight or flight naturally to make sure that they're safe from predators.
I really like how you touched on the fact that it really increases someone's capacity to be more mindful. And as we both know, that is the ultimate helper when it comes to decreasing symptoms of anxiety, depression, PTSD even. Mm-hmm. So Kayla, I could keep this conversation probably going on for hours because I find it fascinating and so valuable. But where could folks learn more information about Trails of Purpose and even connect with you?
Absolutely. So we're across all social media platforms. Facebook is Trails of Purpose Veterans. Instagram is Trails of Purpose. Our website, www.trailsofpurpose.com. You can connect with me directly at Kayla@trailsofpurpose.com for an email. You know, reaching out to us there, getting a really good feel of what we offer. Our website is up to date with all of our media and our services. You know, just another thing, I just want to, you know, remind everybody that Trails of Purpose is free. We're not taking insurance. We're not taking, you know, any type of payment. It is just bring me a statement of service, a DD-214, a hard copy of your orders, come out and proof that you're in the service and you're eligible. It's just
that's
like
amazing.
That.
That is absolutely amazing that you offer this service and free of charge. Kayla, I cannot thank you enough for being on the show today, sharing a piece of your journey and just all the valuable work that you're doing. We really appreciate you.
Thank you so much.
Absolutely. Thank you everyone for tuning in to Calm, Cool, and Connected. We are so glad. And also want to put out the message that therapy doesn't just have to happen in a chair. It can happen out at a barn. It can happen with animals. There is not one size that fits all. And I love what Kayla's doing to promote that message. Thank you so much. Please don't forget to share, like, and subscribe to our podcast. And thank you for tuning in for Calm, Cool, and Connected.